Greetings, everybody. Welcome to this webinar. PIMSOFT's webinar series are designed to promote best practices for the transformation of raw data and measurements into usable digital assets by people, business processes, and other applications. My name is Bernard, and I will be your moderator for today. Your presenter is Marco Lanteri, Industry Principal for Refining and Chemicals at PIMSOFT. Marco, who will be introducing himself briefly, will be speaking from his office, from his home office in Italy, given the current conditions. Today, we are addressing the topic of advanced analytics for the supply chain in the chemical industry. In this webinar, you will discover how SigmaFine transforms data into digital assets to make significant productivity and profitability gains by using model-based approach to validate ERP data and improve planning accuracy, by tracking materials to improve cost and allocation, by inferring important physical properties to improve the overall situational awareness around supply chain management. We thank you for joining us, and we hope you will find this webinar informative and valuable. Before I hand him the microphone, here are a few housekeeping tips to keep in mind during the webinar. The presentation should last approximately 30 minutes, followed by 10 minutes of Q&A. If you have a question, submit it using the chat window on the right-hand side of the screen at any time during the presentation. We will queue the questions one by one at the end, and Marco will answer. Unanswered questions, if any, will be answered by email after webinar and shared with all the attendees. The presentation will be available to you to download in the webinar room, along with the SigmaFine product brochure. We will also send you an email with a link to the presentation, as well as a link to the recording of this webinar in a few days. When you exit the presentation, you will be asked to rate it. Please give us your feedback so we can make this experience and subsequent webinars even more valuable, including suggestions on topics. So thank you for your attention. Now it's my great pleasure to introduce my colleague, Marco, one of our most senior SigmaFine consultants at PIMSOFT.
Thanks, Bernard. Thanks, everyone, attending this webinar today. Let me, before going into the matter, introduce PIMSOFT and SigmaFine. So, especially for who you doesn't know us very well. So I will start from our mission. PIMSOFT's mission is to ensure and improve accuracy, reliability, and usability of process and manufacturing data. And we will see today how our main product, SigmaFine, can support operations and supply chain to achieve such goals. Both PIMSOFT and SigmaFine has quite a long history. It's almost 25 years now, or even more for SigmaFine. We know things change a lot along this time. The product SigmaFine has evolved and still is deeply evolving, both to address new technologies such as web technology, but also new industries and new mandates. Our focus today is regards the supply chain management and how we can support and improve supply chain managers, operations, and planning. I would start with highlighting some major pain points that yourself or your customers are commonly experiencing in different areas. Areas such as planning, when it's sometimes hard to have reliable predictions. Operations, which are whose responses are delayed by the fact that some data are hidden, are not available in real time, or impacted by manual inputs. From the procurement level for pure supply visibility. Traceability, which is another important area. So trace product and the properties associated to a product, allocate costs, production costs associated with type of productions and raw materials, and in the end for sales, pure and untimely data availability. Among all these, we will focus mainly on three areas of the planning, operation, and traceability. And we will see how SigmaFine can address and support such areas through its different modules. So basically balancing capabilities, whether it's mass balance or volume balance, movement management, and moreover, tracking capabilities, which sometimes are not very well exploited, but are very powerful. And we will see some customer stories as well. So let's start with the first topic, which regards the validation of ERP data. In this first case, we will look at the management of a product network. So typically, in a product network, there are receives points for materials. You may have jetties or rail cars, which are delivering materials to your facility. Then the material is distributed and is stored in inventories. And finally, it's shipped, again, through pipelines, rail cars, or other ways. Typically, boundary movements are managed in ERP, especially if we are talking about fiscal data. Whilst distribution inventories are typically historized, their process measurement are historized in a data historian, like for example, the PI system or other databases you may have at your premises. There is a discrepancy in timing between the different data. So typically, ERP data are available at movement closure, and a movement can take can be short, but even long, and can last even more days. Or there is the problem that a movement is crossing midnight, and typically you want balance closure at midnight. While flow meters, level gauges are typically historized in a real-time way, so it doesn't suffer for this time delay. So how to overcome this delay in data availability? Well, for example, through SigmaFine and movement management, we can interact with our other sources from other repositories whilst waiting from the official ERP data. So, for example, scheduling systems or other oil movement system you may have already in place and that are have a database from which to retrieve such information. The granularity of ERP data sometimes is incompatible with the daily balancing requirements. As I was mentioning before, you may have the official closure only days after a movement is officially started, but you need to close the balance of yesterday today. SigmaFine algorithms can split movements, so use the movement information from other data sources and then split in daily chunks and estimate, infer the quantity of each time frame based on our surrounding information, such as flow meters or tank delta stocks, for example. And then in the end, adjust once ERP data are available, the final closure. Again, you may have inconsistencies between what is declared as official data in ERP and or historized in the ERP database and what your metering and level gauging system is telling you. Here, the data validation and reconciliation algorithms of SigmaFine can verify if data from the different sources are in agreement or not, and even spot where the disagreement is and what could be the reason why. We will see now a practical example. This case study regards an ammonia network, which is part of a large chemical facility. In this case, the ammonia is received from barges and rail cars, and then is distributed to other consumers, again, through rail cars and pipelines. And this, all this information is at the boundary, is managed by, in this case, by SAP. The other plant measurement, so such as flow meters and level gauges, are historized, in this case, in a PI system, the production PI system. All this data is aggregated in the SigmaFind model, verified, validated, reconciled, and then finalized reconciled value are written back to the PI system for what regards the metering systems, and also posted to SAP as a reconciled figures for the boundary transfers. By doing this analysis along, this is a trend is showing 1 month of data, and more specifically, we are showing the overall imbalance indicator that SigmaFind provides through its analysis. So it's telling us how much is the overall imbalance of this network, of this product network. And typically, if such imbalance is below 2-3%, the balance is considered quite accurate. Below 5% is moderately accurate, and higher than 5% typically is targeted as having inconsistency to be diagnosed. We see here some behaviors. So typically there is quite a good agreement between reconciled data and original data. But we have, for example, a peak here. And in this case, SigmaFind highlighted the missing declaration of a rail car loading, causing a deviation from the balance point of view. Note that this quantity is quite small compared to the overall quantities managed in the network and stocked in the inventories. But still, SigmaFind could detect such a discrepancy. The biggest deviation instead is regarding a multiple day barge discharge. The inconsistency was related to the different quantities that were originally allocated and that was not in agreement with what the gauging system was measuring. In the SigmaFind model, this was also marked graphically in the model with the red color in the area showing the highest inconsistency. In the end, by applying SigmaFind, this kind of deviation was quickly identified and the customer reported an overall improvement in the balance quality. This is something that is impacting already the supply chain and that you can do just with, in this case, with a mass balance analysis by using carefully the SigmaFind statistical indicators that are provided when running the reconciliation. The focus then we want to pinpoint is the other algorithms that SigmaFind has available, which are the tracking capabilities. By tracking, we mean tracking of materials, but not only materials. Also, whatever logical information you may think of, so like a batch number or an ownership, but also a physical property associated to a mixture of materials. And the goal, indeed, is to improve the economical estimations and support operations in their daily processes. So you may find applications like calculating the cost allocation of a production based on the raw materials, or associate unit yield respect to the material blend that is fed to the process unit. The main benefit that you can achieve are reduced time to both action regarding the operation and to planning. So you can update the planning more frequently and with more reliable data. And we have seen customers reducing their planning update and moving from a weekly or even monthly view or their past process and used to update the plan to a daily update of the plan based on the current situation of their inventories and their productions. Moreover, recalling one of the other keywords we mentioned at the beginning, traceability, which means tracking the business properties from the source to the destination. And we said can be a material name or a material code, but could be even a source, or even thinking to some recent topics, the tracking the carbon footprint of the production based on the routing of the production itself, or even answering questions like how much recycled material is part of my final production, so how much green is my production. Tracking algorithm, but just to give you an overview of what it means, a tracking algorithm is built on top of a balanced model, of a topological model. So in this sense, if you already did the job of building a Sigma Fine model for maybe for the production accounting, there is just a small step to be done to reuse the same model you already built to apply a tracking analysis. In this simple example, tracking follows the material from their source, in this case, a ship and a truck. The ship and the truck are discharging several materials, which are shown with this color, inside three inventories. The inventories here have been configured as well mixed. So the tracking algorithm can manage different ways to make a packet of information to interact each other. The most common for inventories is a well-mixing ideal model. And for pipeline, instead, is a segregated first-in, first-out model. But there are many others available. In this case, the inventories have been initialized with material discharged by the ship and by the truck. And the pipeline is already filled with this orange material. By following the movement that have been declared, the tracking understands and calculates how the different packets, in both in terms of quantity of the overall packet and of fraction of materials, are moving. For example, here from the third tank, some material has been moved inside the pipeline, and accordingly, a similar quantity of material has been fed to the unit. So in this moment, we discover that we are also have a visibility to what is feeding our process unit. And we can go further, so simultaneous loading from two tanks to a pipeline. And again, you see now we have three packets of different blends of material in our pipeline. Still, there is the same orange discharge. And even concurrent movement between loading and unloading of the second tank. And this is granularly taken into account. So it's the timeline, the overall timeline is discretized to better approximate such a concurrent movement. You see that now the unit is fed both with the remaining orange material and also with part of the packet of material containing the other two materials, the green and blue. So in each time frame, we precisely know what is the status of inventories, of the pipelines, and of the feed to the unit. So you can then aggregate all this kind of information to your overall facility. So you can know what's the status of my inventories in terms of material. So how much material 1, 2, 3, and 4 is stored overall in my tank farm. Or the opposite, what's the status of my tanks? So allocate the physical location of my materials. Or even track the material source. So how much and which kind of material has been delivered by the barge or by the trucks? And how is changing the feed of my process unit in time? And as all Sigma Fine analysis, this can be run with a defined time frame. So not only daily, but we have customers running this on dedicated process unit even hourly, on an hourly basis. This trend shows for 1 month, again, 1 month of data, what is the impact of the feed to this unit of these four materials against the yield of the unit itself. So here is unlocking a better operation, better operations, because each you have a clear impact of the kind of materials respect to the unit yield. The feed is typically not very well known, so unless you have an online analyzer directly on your feed, and the tracking algorithm basically supplies, acts as like a soft sensor, a soft analyzer online, giving you the current situation and without the need of a dedicated analyzers, or supplying information when analyses are not available. We will see now a real case. This is a story that has been presented together with Eni Versalis in their aromatic plant based in Priolo, Sicily. You can see the full story on our website in the testimonials section. But so here we will go briefly to the main points. So in this plant, there are some critical material properties to be monitored in order to efficiently operate the plant itself. More specifically, are the content, the chemical content of the chemical composition of the feed in terms of benzene, toluene, xylenes, etc., plus some other properties which are giving you the flavor of how aliphatic, how conjugate, how many conjugated olefins, or how many much aliphatic or aromatic content is in the mix. Their problem was essentially related to a data quality problem related to data and availability. Data and availability both in terms of available compositions and also of data workflow. They had to wait days for lab data to come back. The monitoring was done offline. There was not a clear visibility of how the inventories were managed in terms of materials stored inside the inventories. So there was just the availability of some level gauges, and that's it. So in order to improve both operations and planning, Versalis wanted to implement a solution, an automated solution, to give visibility to the data from the receipt points to the plant. What we did was to implement a dedicated model for the feed of the aromatic plant, including the modeling of the inventories, In this case, we have five dedicated tanks for the aromatic plant, and monitoring, tracking the materials in terms of material type, quantity, and then estimating the compositions and the other two qualities that we mentioned before, from again, from the inventory till the plant feed, and providing them online on a daily basis. And we achieved to do that. Here we you can see 1 month of data. In the histogram, we represent how materials are moved from the inventory to the feed. So these are the material codes and the associated quantity. And in the trend above, the estimated qualities at feed. In this case, we are showing the most important for them. And we see quite a clear correlation between material types and estimated qualities. This might sound even trivial, but you need to consider that all this information was not available before. So the operators were completely blind against what was the exact feed to the unit. There was only a monthly overview of how the plant performed. So basically, operations knew the information too late, and planning could be updated only mostly at month end. So the great change that has been that led to the big improvement in the plant itself was moving operation to have a clear view of what was happening every day. So to improve the operation of the unit itself. On the more on the supply chain level, the planning could update much frequently their plan. They could optimize the logistic, especially in terms of inventory usage, as now they had clear visibility of the load and the kind of material stored on each inventory day by day. They reduce the costs, the demurrage costs, as due to improvement in planning. They could decide better the time when to book a ship and unload the material from the ship to the right inventory. So, and leading to an optimized logistics. So, as to wrap up, I just, instead of doing a summary, I prefer to share with you some questions. Questions that could be answered through the implementation of SigmaFind tracking. Or SigmaFind tracking can play a central role in addressing some of this question. I think it could be a good starting point also for the question and answer session and further discussion. So just to recap, production allocation, correlation between feed and unit yield, how to close the prediction made by the planning respect to the actuals, allocate productions in terms of costs or of process routes, and last but not least, answer questions like how much green is my supply chain or how much circular, using another quite common word now, is my supply chain. So how I'm able to recycle materials, reuse materials in my final production. So what is the footprint of my production? So just as a small recap, so we have seen how to measure the consistency between ERP data and physical measurement, and how mass balance done by SigmaFind with the statistical indicator can pinpoint such discrepancies. Reduce time to action, both on planning and operation, tracking algorithm, and the benefit of quality tracking in estimating physical properties when these are not available or not available at the right time. Bernard, I'm finished. I leave to you for the closure.
Thank you, Marco, for this great presentation. We have some questions queued up. I'll go through them one by one for the audience. If you have more questions, just keep sending them via the chat window on the right-hand side of the screen. Let's start with our first question. Can SigmaFind monitor inter-unit product movement within the plant?
Yes. We need to have, of course, the information of the movements. So in the presentation, I've shown the case of receipt, so the boundary transfers, so from a receipt point to a feed, but you could even follow, for example, materials that are coming out from a unit or from intermediate tanks and follow from that point to the final production. So you can go up also in the other on the other area, of course. So if you have already, let's say, a SigmaFind facility model in place, you can decide if you want to build a tracking analysis on top. You can enable the portion of the model where you want to do such tracking.
Wouldn't the barge loading be monitored with some type of flow meter? Why couldn't we do the balance against the integrated loading during the time period of interest?
During a barge loading or unloading, yes, there is a meter. Well, the meter can be, the problem is that the meter can be either on the, facility side or on the barge side. So it's, here it's more a fiscal problem rather than a flow metering problem. So what we, in the case I presented, we cross-checked the data with, in that case of the ammonia, with the delta stock of the inventories. In some cases, you can have, if available, a flow meter also in along the pipeline. So this depends also on the arrangement. The problem is that the fiscal data, the closure data of the fiscal meter, which is managed by the ERP, is typically available only once the transfer is closed. And this is the big impact in the delay of in managing such data. That is also causing delays, for example, in the balancing and the accounting team. So that's why we had to managing this way. So first infer what could be the quantity, allocate day by day according to the portion of quantity transferred, and then do a final closure once the ERP official data was released.
Here is another question. Does SigmaFind need inventory and movement data from any movement monitoring application like Honeywell movement monitoring, or data I store from Historian is sufficient for mass balancing?
Okay. This depends on... let's say it's not mandatory, but I would say in 90% of the cases, you need movement data. Where there's not... not necessary, this needs to be picked up by the movement monitoring application. It depends on where they are stored. So in some cases, for example, you have some scheduled movement. And in that case, we can acquire the scheduled movement and then through our IMM module managed through a workflow and say if that scheduled movement was really activated and how to close the quantity based on flow meters or inventories. Let's say otherwise, if you are already historizing such movement in the historian. Okay, we can retrieve from the historian. But let's say in most of the cases, we see that historian typically addresses, let's say, process data, whilst movements are in some other databases. Being, let's say, a dedicated application or just a custom database or even Excel.
Is real-time tracking of inventory in the tank and inter-tank product movement possible in Sigma Fine?
We typically talk about, I wouldn't talk about real-time. We can go near real-time. In case of tracking, I have seen cases of till hourly tracking. I don't think it does much sense to go below 1 hour. So from an algorithm point of view, yes, it's feasible. What's always need to be assessed is when movement data are available. So it's always mean we need always to make a representation through a model of the reality. So if such movement data are available and in an automated way, yes, you can do that. If not, you are stuck with when the movement data are available. So that's, let's say, the low step of the chain. It's not the tracking itself. Just to complete the answer, and I will, in the presentation you will receive, there are a few slides more. And there is one slide dedicated to that. In reality, typically you have the balance that spans, for example, 1 day, the movements that span whatever time frame, more than 1 day, less than 1 day. The tracking slices the overall balance day in the pieces of the different movements, and then goes even more granular to approximate reality. So this complement.
Yeah. Okay, great. Very good. Thank you. Here's another question. Are the primary financial benefits used by clients to justify Sigma Fine installations?
Well, let's say, given that it's the main driver for Sigma Fine in refining and chemicals is the production accounting. The first driver is the necessity to have a validation and a closure of the balance. So this is really an accounting necessity. Then on top of that, what we have shown today instead, it's a use of Sigma Fine that goes beyond this basic level. And the first benefit, let's say the main benefit is the reduced time to action. We have seen a reduced time to action on one side on the operations, specifically by knowing more about what is feeding your units and how the unit is behaving, you reduce your time to action. The other one was reduce time to action for the planning on two ways. One was you have a reconciliation, so you have much more accuracy in looking at your unit, so you can take the reconciled yield of your unit and you can backcast them to the as a new planning vectors. So on a long term, you reduce the gap between what you are thinking where to go and where you actually you are. So the delta between planned data and actual data. So this is one thing. The other was, as in the case exposed by ENI, having a better knowledge of the exact allocation of all materials in all the inventories improves the way how you manage the logistics. So how you manage your inventories and the decision-making regarding the logistics itself. In the, let's say, just to anticipate, maybe Bernard is not the today topic, but in a next step, episode of this webinar series. We will see another use instead in the energy, so an application of.
Okay, it looks like we lost Marco. We lost the audio.
Fine. Okay, performance monitoring through energy balance. So if you think how many fees you can address just with our software, I guess the trend is this flexibility that can give. I find quite amazing.
Okay, thank you, Marco. We're coming to the end of this webinar. We have a few unanswered questions. So like we said, we will take those questions and include them in the information we're going to share with you, which will include the recording and the presentation. You will access it as you exit the webinar today. So Marco, on behalf of all the participants and PIMSOFT, we thank you for taking the time to put together this webinar. It was very interesting. And if you want to contact Marco, please do so. His contact info should be, yes, it's on the slide right now. So don't hesitate to contact him directly if you have additional questions. So to everybody, thank you for attending. Again, do not forget to rate your experience as you exit the webinar. It's a simple task, but it's very valuable to us because this is the only way we can improve. Thank you very much. The webinar will be closing now.
Thanks so much everybody.